The beautiful reconciliation that, I mean, I was crying in thankfulness at the beginning. The reconciliation parts were beautiful. When when the brother read in Aramaic, the scripture as well with the Jewish brother, and then the Turkish and Armenian brothers who are just, you know, arm in each other. And they had a great tragedy of a genocide amongst those people, and they are giving us testimony in video, just weeping during that.
What about the Catholic?
The Italian Catholic guy. Same thing. I just spent the whole morning crying again, and I'm not a crier. I mean, you're more.
I'm a crier.
Than super crier.
super crier.
I don't know.
Is that what you call me?
Super crier.
So, I'm a super crier. That's just not right, man.
Come on. I've been with you 25 years. Yeah. So compared to me. That's all I'm saying. I actually think it's strength. Just right, boss?
Impartation.
But just the gladness of just the humility of everybody who got up there. Kissing the shoes because they couldn't wash their loose feet. And so the mutual kissing of the feet of each other. I mean, it was so humble. To be a part of, so powerful. And the young man, I don't know his name, who began to just speak about on behalf of the African-American community, he was amazingly powerful.
Yes.
I mean, when he just said, he was strong and fierce and direct and told the truth, and it was, I felt it got uncomfortable for a moment as he was talking, and yet as he was breaking through some of the things, and he said something so powerful. He said, when you hear that phrase, Black Lives Matter, he just began to say, hear the grief of the African-American community, hear the groan and the cry of the grieving. Will you notice the wound? Will you see the wound? Deeply powerful. And I could feel it reorienting that political thing that we buy into sometimes. The subtle racism of our heart, the big city is against a small city, that's happening there but not here, all these things. He just kind of reoriented that in the whole environment. It was powerful, and it was amazing. And I have to pray into it more, but his concept of wasn't the Lord's heart to have a civil rights movement. He wanted actually Azusa to flow into the races being united in a way never before, that was one of the things that was thwarted. And he just reminded us that Azusa was 50 years after the end of the Civil War, and that it was, just at that time, the Lord powerfully moved with the Comforter. The tagline, he said, was "The Comforter has come." And he said that the African-American people needed the Comforter at that time, and he had come, and all that was in Azusa. And then that was thwarted. And so the civil rights movement for him, I got to chew on it, was the Lord, a second move of grace of what the Lord intended to do through Azusa, through the Church of Jesus Christ. I mean, that is a ton to chew on in the spirit and in history, but it was beautiful, very meaningful. A real deposit was made that we need to continue to look at from his ministry that day.